We're going to talk about the format painter. Most people are aware of the format painter. So for example, we have two words here and one is formatted with a different type of font and it's bold. And so you just click on that and you click on the format painter, and then you can copy that formatting over to another cell. And that works very quick, and it works very well if you're stepping into somebody else's worksheet and you don't know how they formatted it. It's an easy way to make sure that your information looks the same as theirs. But there is far more things that the format painter can do for you. So let's go through a few of them. So for example, here I have a timesheet that I've done, and I've set up the client name in a particular font. I've set up the shading and everything. So now I would like to select the whole sheet and copy the formatting of all this sheet. I'm not trying to copy the formulas and the information. I just want the formatting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click between the A and the one in this little square box here. I'm going to click on my format painter, and I'm going to go to the next sheet. Now I'm going to click on that box again with my format painter, and instantly I have my formatting copied from one sheet to the other. This works well if you're changing the information and possibly the formulas, and you just want the formatting that you spent so long getting ready to copy to the next sheet. Now, if you notice, we're going to type in your name here, and it has copied the format of the font and the size, and it's also copied the merge and center here. And on my other timesheet, I have it formatted so that it turns red if it's greater than 8 hours. So what we're going to do is we're going to type in 5, 5, and 5. And then I'm going to do an automatic sum here. And automatically, whatever I get here turns red because it's greater than 8. So we're not done with our tricks or our great benefits of the format painter. Let's go on to conditional formatting. So here I have a task list that is quite a bit of information that I've tried to conditionally format. Now, the project starts on the 1st of May and ends on the 1st of September. The total number of days is 123. The total number of days that we have gone so far is 40. And I've done a little formula here saying dividing by the days that we've gone so far as opposed to the divided by the total days of the project. And we get a 33% complete in time. I have this conditionally formatted so that tasks that the percentage complete put in by the project managers are indicated here. And those that are less than the 33% will turn red. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on the task here. We're going to go to conditional formatting, and we are going to go to manage rules so you can see what I have done here. And so I have, if it is greater than 33% complete, it'll turn green, and if it's less, it's going to turn red. Note that when I set this up, the B3, which is the percentage column, I have taken the dollar sign out of the 3, so it's indicating that it can be applied to other cells in this column. Now we're going to go OK. Further down we have task 7, 8, 9, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the task 1 that is highlighted in red, and I'm going to click the format painter, and I'm going to apply it to task 7, 8, 9, and there you see that the conditional formatting has been copied from one cell with the format painter to the other cells in our list. So this saves a lot of time and a lot of calculations. Please subscribe.